High tunnels require environmental temperature control. The clear polyethylene plastic allows the high tunnel to warm up during the day, but the nighttime temperature under that structure will be about the same as outside. And you're going to get a freeze or a frost and you're growing warm season crops, you may need to provide some supplemental heat to get you through those cold nights or cold early mornings. There's a couple different ways that you can do that. One, you can add propane portable heaters to provide heat throughout that high tunnel. So here we have our simple propane heater. This is just a standard grill type propane tank. We have a little heating element up here. There's a valve with an off, low, medium, high switch, and a heating element like this can put out about 15,000 BTUs per hour. On this high tunnel that we're in, it's a 30 by 70 high tunnel. You would want to have three, maybe four of these structures or these heaters in the high tunnel. We want to make sure that we space them out, place them in the row in order to get good airflow of that heat throughout the high tunnel. You don't want to set these too close to the plants. This heating element gets very, very warm and you can actually have some singeing of these plant leaves if it's too close. So again, kind of stick it out here in the middle of the aisle. If you put those portable heaters in, I do recommend that you have some sort of circulation moving that heat throughout the high tunnel to make sure you have a good, even heat distribution. Once temperatures warm up in the morning, go ahead and open up that high tunnel a little bit and let it vent out just in case you end up with a carbon dioxide or carbon monoxide buildup within the high tunnel, and then go ahead and turn off those heater units. So here we have an end wall vent in our Gothic style high tunnel. The nice thing about these Gothic style high tunnels is that they have a large ridge up above these doors, so we can put a vent up there that can really help move air throughout this high tunnel. So we've got the doors, we've got the sidewalls over here that are all opened up, but heat rises, and so we can get a big trapping of hot air up along that top of the high tunnel. So by having these top vents, we can really push that warm air out of the structure. You'll see we have one on both ends. We can even, you know, change this vent here and make it actually have a fan, and we can actually use electricity to push that hot air out. So we can move air from one end of the high tunnel with the fan, push it on through the high tunnel and out the other end with another fan to suck it out. As an alternative to the heater units, you can use a spunbond polyester fabric. Now, spunbond polyester products do kind of have a bad rap in the field, particularly in windy locations, because they need to be held down to the soil. However, in a high tunnel that's all closed up, there's no wind. So you simply need to place that spunbond product over the plants to provide protection. The great advantage about those products inside the high tunnel is that where you would get 2 or 3 to 5 degrees protection out in the field, you get 10 to 15 degrees of frost protection inside that high tunnel with those products. We can also use water to our benefit to help maintain temperature within our high tunnel. Water has the ability to absorb a lot of energy during bright, sunny days. Well, that energy, as we go into nighttime and early morning, is released back off into the environment, providing a little bit of protection. So we can use water in a couple ways. We can irrigate the ground and store the energy that way, or we can keep large water tanks inside the high tunnel and allow the energy to radiate out from those tanks. Now, you may not get a lot of protection, but sometimes all you need is 1 or 2 degrees. The size of the high tunnel does make a difference when it comes to heating and cooling the structure. The larger the high tunnel, the more buffered it is. That means that it will be slower to heat up during the day and it'll be slower to cool down at night. If you have a small high tunnel and it turns sunny in the morning, you need to get outside right away and make sure that it gets opened up so it does not get too hot inside that high tunnel. Likewise, at night, you need to make sure you get out there and close it up early afternoon before it gets too cold. Now, cooling the high tunnel, we primarily do that by opening up the sides, the end walls. Sometimes we have rooftop vents, and sometimes we have end wall vents. The key with a high tunnel is to get as much airflow going through that structure to move that warm air out of the building. Sometimes with a high tunnel, we will even see growers add automated vents to open up when it hits 75, 80 degrees. Sometimes we also see growers add fans to push air from one end to the other in order to help cool it. In addition to the fans and the vents, some growers will use a shade cloth on top of the structure in order to minimize how much light is coming through the polyethylene plastic. Now, what is common is to not put on that shade cloth until June, July, depending on when temperatures really warm up for the spring. We also typically use anywhere from a 30 to a 40% shade restriction. If we go higher than that, we can very commonly see plants under light stress and starting to elongate and stretch out. So don't go too high with your shade cloth. Heating and cooling is an important management strategy to the success of your high tunnel. High tunnels have been gaining a lot of traction across the upper Midwest in the last 10 years, and rightfully so. They're the number one production type technology that's really driving the local foods movement across the Midwest. But what is a high tunnel?